On this edition of One Championship Weekly, One Championship is in Yangon, Myanmar, for the third event of 2018, with Quest for Gold on the 23rd of February. The battle for the One Light Heavyweight World Championship highlights the night. One middleweight world champion and Myanmar national hero, Aung La N Sang, squares off against Alexandre Machado for a shot at a second division title. You're watching One Championship Weekly. On the 23rd of February, at One Championship's Quest for Gold in Yangon, Myanmar, two highly respected martial artists go head-to-head in the One Light Heavyweight World Championship. Brazilian BJJ champion Alexandre Machado takes on Myanmar's national hero and One middleweight champion Aung La N Sang in the main event. Myanmar's sporting icon is also a BJJ expert, and it's not easy to escape the python once he's got you on the ground. Mohamed Ali found out the hard way when he faced Aung La.
When they stand side by side, it's Mohamed Ali who is the older man. Aung La N Sang is 5 centimeters taller. Egypt against Myanmar.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is our main event. This is 3 rounds of 5 minutes in the One Championship middleweight division, and it's presented to you by AGD Bank. Our three judges scoring this fight at cage side are Joey Lepitan from the Philippines, Jonathan Lai from Canada, and Chris Kelly from the United States. Myanmar, we are one! Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, this man is an Egyptian wushu champion, standing at 180 centimeters tall, holding a professional MMA record of 10 wins, 7 losses. Representing Egyptian Sandus School Team, fighting Alexandria, Egypt, give it up for Mohamed Ali Felix! And now, introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, he is a Burmese MMA champion, standing at 185 centimeters tall, with a professional MMA record of 16 wins, 9 losses, and 1 no contest. Representing Crazy 88 MMA, fighting out of Maryland, USA, from Myanmar, please roar for Aung La, Burmese Python, and Sir! When this battle begins, your referee in charge, Yuji Shimada.
Will they be able to hear what Yuji says over the noise that this crowd's making?
Do not attack back, okay? Clean fight, clean fight. Anytime, obey command, okay? Go back, Conan.
That's Ivanka Hua. That's Muhammad Ali. And that is Aung La N Sang.
You ready? 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 Go!
This fight brought to you by AGD Bank, our main event of the evening. The crowd here, by far the noisiest they've been all night, and they've participated all evening long.
Aung La N Sang knows that he gets overexcited, and he's trying to calm down and really have his composure, not get utilize his game plan. He's got too excited in fights before, and it's cost him the bout. So this time he really wants to settle down, calm himself, not get overexcited by this crazy atmosphere that's here, and control the fight.
It's Muhammad Ali who wants to make the quicker start. Aung La N Sang does look pretty calm. Boxing closed mouth, thunderous left hand, but it's caught by Muhammad Ali.
You wouldn't think that Muhammad Ali would want this fight to go to the ground. He's a little bit tentative to engage.
Yes, so Yuji sees that. Ooh. Now Yuji called him to stand up. Muhammad Ali changed his mind, but it's too late by that time. Up they get. Fighting out of the southpaw stance there. Aung La N Sang switches occasionally.
Mohamed Ali is just coming in with big shots.
Both hands landing, the right hand going upstairs, the knee coming back, but it's the busy right hand of Mohamed Ali that's doing all the work there in the stand-up.
It's a dirty boxing style, as he just kind of grabs the back of Aung La N Sang's head and starts throwing those uppercuts and hooks. This is what Aung La N Sang's got to kind of slow everything down, really gauge control of this fight, and he's trying to use that outside trip. Nice little technique.
Drags him down. Mohamed Ali to his knees. But then Ali goes for the single leg.
Now, we're going to see what Aung La N Sang's like off of his back. This is Mohamed Ali really trying to hand fight there, control the hands. Nice little butterfly sleep. We've seen this before.
Crowd making rapturous noise here at the Tijuana Stadium.
We've seen that same move before, that same butterfly sweep, but Mohamed Ali was able to roll, continuously roll out of it and get out of that position.
Switches to orthodox, Aung La N Sang, as the crowd's noise rings in his ears. Again, Mohamed Ali goes for the single leg.
Oh, there's a possible guillotine, it's deep.
He's tapped out. It's over. Just over 2.5 minutes of the opening round, and Aung La N Sang has pleased this crowd beyond their imagination. Everybody is on their feet, applauding and taking photographs. He's come home, and he's delighted the nation.
Aung La N Sang faces Alexandre Machado next for the one light heavyweight world title on the 23rd of February. Ariel Sexton has an impressive 100% finishing rate, with over three quarters of his victories coming via submission. The BJJ champion from Costa Rica is merciless on the ground. Sexton expertly demonstrated his submission skills in this bout against Anvar Elizanov.
32 years old, Sexton is 7 years older than Alizanov. He's also 3 centimeters taller. This is Costa Rica against Russia.
Ladies and gentlemen and fight fans from all around the world, welcome to the most exciting mixed martial arts event. This is ONE Fighting Championship, Dynasty of Champions. We're now live globally, so get ready for a night of non-stop MMA action. This first fight is 3 rounds of 5 minutes. In the ONE FC lightweight division, and it's brought to you by Star Sports. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, this man is a BJJ practitioner, standing at 178 centimeters tall, weighing in at 70.3 kilograms, holding a professional MMA record of 8 wins, 3 losses, and 1 no contest. Fighting out of team, Daniel Gracie, an athletic advance, representing Costa Rica, two-time BJJ champion, Ariel Tarzan Sexton! Oh! And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, is a Muay Thai fighter and a wrestler, standing at 175 centimeters tall, weighing in at 70 kilograms, with a professional MMA record of 3 wins, no losses. Fighting out of AKA Thailand, he is Kazakhstan freestyle wrestling champion, representing Russia, Anvar Keprosos Alizanov! And when his battle begins, your referee in charge, Olivier Cost.
My fighters, watch out for headbutt, low blows, back of the head and spine. As you know, no full stomp to the head, okay? Don't grab the fence. Defend my corner at all time, defend yourself at all time. Touch glove if you want, back your corner.
That's Han Ji-eun.
Judge, time. Ready?
That's Ariel Sexton. Fight! And that's Anvar Alizanov. This fight brought to you by Star Sports in the lightweight division.
I want to see if Ariel has a hard time adapting to Anwar's.
Oh, he's taken a big right hand and gone down. And Anvar immediately has the upper hand.
Beautiful sweep. Gets back on top. Anvar on bottom right now. he's been working his jiu-jitsu a lot the last 2 months, he was telling me, but he's dealing with a black belt, you know, a Hensel Gracie black belt.
Don't grab the shot.
What people need to understand is that grappling is like a chess match. You're jockeying for all sorts of little positions, from wrist control to arm control. I mean, he's got a leg, he's leg riding him right now. He's got a leg on the inside of his. Anwar looks to turn and face, can't get there.
He's got his back. This is dangerous for Anwar.
Yeah. I can't really see the position he's at from where we're sitting.
From this angle, it's difficult.
Work to finish, Ariel.
There it is, not quite underneath the chin.
Ariel's covering the mouth, trying to get him to lift his chin to fight the hand off the mouth, and then he'll attack right away underneath the neck for the rear naked. Ariel right to mount. Nice transition from back to mount. Ariel really controlling this this grappling match here. He's got him belly down. He's going to hip in just like he did right there. He's letting the big punches go. Now, if Anwar turns his back and gives up, there he goes. He's looking to sink that chin. See how he's got his hand over the mouth? When he puts a hand over the mouth, Anwar's going to lift his chin to try and get the hand off, and then that's when he'll look to attack underneath the chin.
Caught a couple of good left hands from Sexton. He has to be careful about hitting Anwar on the back of the head. Olivier Costas asked him to watch that carefully, and now he's saying work to finish.
I love this position where he has the figure four around the body, and he's working that half. He's working that that half Nelson.
Catch.
On the back of the head. Now he's going to transition right back to the mount. Beautiful transitions. Never really let go of the figure four around the waist. Anwar needs to push. You hear his corner yelling, hands on the hips, hands on the hips.
Work to finish.
For the mount escape. You got to push on those hips. He right now, he's just turning side to side. Big punches right now from Ariel.
And Anwar, remember, came into this fight just on a few days' notice, and he's learning now what he's let himself in for.
He's about to make that transition to the arm bar. He's actually got a reverse triangle set in. Anwar's sitting on the leg now, so it's hard for Ariel to finish. He's going to need to scoot a little bit more off to the side. There he goes. He's got it locked, reverse triangle position. You'll see he's going to try and break the grip.
Anwar's holding on to that hand of his to try and prevent that arm bar.
The grip's broken. He'll look to extend the arm. Oh, key lock.
That looks horrible, and it's over, yeah. Thank goodness for that, because it looked as if that was going to be severe trouble for Anwar. Brave man to come in at such short notice. His record falls to 3-1 as Ariel Sexton improves his record to 9-3-0-1.
Lightweight athletes collide next in Yangon when Ariel Sexton takes on Malaysian hero Ev Ting on the 23rd of February. Russia's Timofey Nastyukhin is one of the most powerful knockout artists in ONE Championship. The Pancratian champion showed his range, delivering a knockout when he took out Edouard Folayong with a spectacular knee.
This is how they stack up. Quite a big difference in age. Folayong, the older man by 6 years. Nastyukhin is 7 centimeters taller. This is Russia against the Philippines.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next fight is 3 rounds of 5 minutes in the ONE FC lightweight division. And it's brought to you by Petron, fuel for everyone. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, this man is a Pancratian fighter, standing at 177 centimeters tall, weighing in at 70 kilograms, holding a professional MMA record of 7 wins, 1 loss. Fighting out of Russia top team, he is the FILA Pancratian champion from Russia, Timofey Nastyukhin! And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, he is a wushu fighter, standing at 170 centimeters tall, weighing in at 70 kilograms, with a professional MMA record of 14 wins, 4 losses. Fighting out of Team Lakai, presenting your hometown hero, Filipino welterweight champion, Edward Landslide Folayong! And when the action begins, your referee in charge, Yuji Shimada.
Fight.
5 minutes, 3 rounds. No headbutting, not a groin, and no grabs of hands. On the ground, do not stomp the face, okay? Clean fight, catch ropes. Edward Garner.
Hans Earn.
Judge.
Telling us that this is the beginning of the contest. Yuji Shimada gets us underway. This fight brought to you by Petron, fuel for everyone.
For Timofey to come out real hard and aggressive. Big punch right there. They both landed.
Will this go beyond the first round then? That's the question we've been asking. Timofey says no, don't really want it to do that. Already landed big right hands and that kick. What can Edward do? He was warned by Josh about the fast start.
Well, people throw at the power that both these guys are throwing with. They generally don't have good cardio. But Edward, he's obviously gone the distance. Oh, he's rocked.
They're swinging for the fences.
You can tell Timofey's got a lot of power in his hands.
He really does, and he's quick too, and he puts everything into those punches, doesn't he? I think the first time Edward went down, he was kind of off balance, but he was knocked off balance, to be fair.
He's been knocked off balance, though, at least twice now in this first 20 seconds, 30 seconds of the round. Timofey's being a little cautious, though. Timofey's setting it up really nice. He's kind of fading that little bit of a jab coming over the top with the right hand. He's also looking to catch the kick and throw the right hand at the same time. He's done it twice now.
Look for Edward to kick quite a lot. Another of these wushu fighters. He enjoys, I was just about to say, a spinning back fist. I was going to suggest that he might not have time to throw them in this fight because Timofey looks so up for it and so quick. But no, he's got one off already. He'll do a spinning back kick as well from time to time.
Timofey lands that right hand again. They're still kind of, believe it or not, they're still kind of in the filling out process.
it's the touchiest feeling out process I've ever seen, I think.
One's throwing one and two. When they start throwing twos and threes, though, like, what I mean by that is they're throwing two and three punch kicks combination.
Right hand from Timofey. Caught Edward flush.
Another one right there.
Really throws with bad intention, as Mike Tyson used to say, doesn't he?
Timofey's finding that mark, though, every time. It's just a matter before he finds the tip of the chin. You see Edward looking to set up a spinning back kick or a spinning back fist, something along those lines. He's turning his body sideways.
Caught again, I think, there, Edward. Just puts everything into those right hands, the Russian.
Well, we're halfway through the round, which is about that's longer than he's gone in half of his fights.
Oh, there it is, the spinning back kick.
Just missed. Timofey did the right thing. He stepped in to close the distance, so he wasn't able to get hit with that spinning back kick.
Edward can take that spinning back kick upstairs as well. This one landed much lower, around the hips.
Whoa. Caught him again with that right hand.
He did. He's got a pretty good chin, Edward. Cuts fairly frequently.
What Timofey is doing?
Oh, the knee to the head.
The winner.
That was a devastating finish.
That was unbelievable.
And really, it happened so quickly that it was hard to conceive for a moment.
I think I just threw Rich Franklin off of his chair.
Yeah, you nearly knocked me sideways as well, buddy. But that, I mean, it was worth it. What a finish that was.
Wow. I think I almost fell off my chair.
Now, I'm looking at Edward in the cage, and he's up on his feet to the great relief of everybody in this arena.
You can hear the crowd go. They're really cheering for him.
Wow, they love Edward Balayan. And rightly so. He's a wonderful, wonderful man, school teacher, very pious individual.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Yuji Shimada calls a halt to this battle at 3:11 of round number one for your winner via knockout, Timofey Nastyukhin.
Knockout artists meet in the one cage on the 23rd of February, when Timofey Nastyukhin squares off against Amir Khan. One Championship heads to Yangon, Myanmar on the 23rd of February with Quest for Gold. The One Light Heavyweight World Title headlines the night. Myanmar national hero and one middleweight world champion Aung La N Sang returns home. He goes up against Alexandre Machado for a shot at a second division title. Check your local listings or find it online at 1ppv.com. You've been watching One Championship Weekly.